Building codes are the first line of defense against earthquakes. So the important thing with building codes is that if you design your bridges or your buildings or your infrastructure to withstand shaking, then it doesn't matter when that earthquake occurs. If it's tomorrow or in 10 years or in 50 years, if the infrastructure survives the shaking, then you'll be able to continue with continue operations. People will be able to live in their homes and buildings after the earthquake as they were before the earthquake. So the research that we're doing here will help save lives during future earthquakes here in Canada and in other areas of the world, will help us to design infrastructure to withstand shaking from these types of large earthquakes, and will also allow for informed decision making when it comes to critical infrastructure. This is the key information that regulators need, decision makers need, planners need in making decisions in their communities or in their province or in their country. So we have in place automated systems, seismic recordings, seismic signals from all of our seismographs across Canada. More than 150 instruments are being fed into computers in both Ottawa and here in Victoria in real time. And those computers are monitoring constantly and locating and detecting earthquakes. So we have automated systems in place that are monitoring and locating and providing information within minutes, within 2 to 3 minutes typically, of any large earthquake anywhere in Canada. Get the information out to emergency responders, to the media, to engineers who are interested, bridge engineers, structural engineers, are all looking for that information. What happened? How did the ground shake? Over what area? And then they can send out crews and engineers to inspect infrastructure. So the idea is to save lives and to save money, to make our communities safer, to make our infrastructure safer, and to ensure that after the earthquake, we're in the best possible position that we can be.